Long, long time ago, I can still remember how, alas, poor Yorick's jokes drew groans. He'd dance and sing and kiss my hand like Elsinore was Neverland. But then he went and joined the Skull and Bones. And now, Horatio, I get shivers with every line the ghost delivers. All the globe has been dark, 'cause something rots in Denmark. I can't recall a thing as weird as when dear old Daddy reappeared to say that he'd been poison-eared the day King Hamlet died. So to be or to choose not to be, that's the question I'm digesting in my soliloquy. And when fortune aims its slings and arrows at me, tell me how I'm gonna live through Act Three. Answer, please, iambically. Did you like Shakespeare in love? And did you rewind for scansion of Gwyneth with her wardrobe gone? Now, do you believe in English lit? Is brevity the soul of wit? If so, then why's this bloody place so long? Well, I know this role has real cachet for each Branagh and Olivier, and Mel Gibson draws blood nice. Man, I dig that passion of Christ. I was a young Great Dane in British schools with my pet Ophelia and a dad who rules. But I knew we'd been played for fools the day King Hamlet died. So here's the question: to be or choose rather to be suicidal, or to idle apathetically? Or is volition all it's cracked up to be? If to die, to sleep, to dream is lovely, please explain the question to me. Less than 2 months since the obit ran, and Lord knows frailty, thy name's woman. My dumbass uncle wears dad's ring. So I set the stage for a royal sting. What a script! I thought the play's the thing where I'll catch the conscience of the king. Oh, and while the king enjoyed the show, the players showed him whack his bro. The king stomped off and cried, OJ yelled homicide. So let's make a deal, Queen Mother, who is behind curtain number two? How now, a rat? I sliced him through the day Polonius died. I was thinking, to be or to go with plan B? Is it nobler just to soldier on Shakespeareanly, or to fly off to the undiscovered country? Thus my conscience makes a coward of me. Get me to a fun nunnery. Hanky panky? Nope, Ophelia's cranky. Could she be ticked that I nailed that Yankee? Or maybe 'cause I knifed her dad? She shouted,
foul!
In her wrath,
you'll never tread on my primrose path.
Guess my joke about country matters made her mad. Now the nymph went nutso north-northwest, went and took a swim, completely dressed. She sank just like a ship. So here's the moral, skinny dip. Poor Laertes missed his tour de France, but merde, this ain't no cheap romance. Ask Guildenstern and Rosencrantz the day Ophelia died. I kept on thinking, to be or to other than be? That's the question. Screw depression, death sounds painless to me. This tooth too solid, flesh should melt, melt like brie, and resolve into a fondue for me. Serve it with some crumpets and tea. Oh, place, equipped with poison, swords and mace, with fortune there to shape our end. So come on, fence me nimble, fence me quick. Don't tase me, bro, with your tainted prick, or bet your royal ass we're foiled again. But Laertes and I both got poked. Mom drank some Chinese lead-based coke. The king was SOL. Thus sends his sword a tale. I said,
my name is Hamlet Jr., guy. You killed my dad. Prepare to die.
Yes, I stole that from the prince's bride the day King Claudius died. Here's the question, to be or choose alternately. That's the question I'm processing in scene one of act three. To end these shocks or bear them heartachingly, quoting sonnet number 73. That one's too depressing for me. I met a girl named Juliet, and her boyfriend whose name I forget. What's in a name, man, anyway? I led Othello to his death and made life a bitch for King Macbeth, till the bard said, dude, you're in a different play. So meanwhile, back at Elsinore, a bunch of guys come to mop the floor. It's Fortinbras's legions. I guess we're now Norwegians. And the three cold stars I rye of most, Laertes' mom and King Claudius, went off to hang with Daddy's ghost the day Prince Hamlet died. To be or choose oppositely, are we tougher if we suffer indefatigably? Or take up arms against a turbulent sea of the troubles fortune slinging at me? Screw it, let's go watch some TV. We were thinking to be or to not freaking be. That's the question we're obsessing about interminably. But as for us, the answer's clear not to be caught in this Shakespearean tragedy.
Good night, sweet prince.
I'm not quite dead.